हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, ओके, मल्टीपर्पस रिवर वैली प्रोजेक्ट्स। मल्टीपर्पस रिवर वैली प्रोजेक्ट्स एज द नेम सजेस्ट, इट इज दोज प्रोजेक्ट्स फ्रॉम व्हिच मल्टीपल बेनिफिट्स आर डिराइव्ड। एक्चुअली ए डैम इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड ऑन द रिवर्स एंड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ द डैम नंबर ऑफ बेनिफिट्स आर डिराइव्ड। लाइक it can dam is constructed with the purpose of serving irrigational water, it can help in generation of hydroelectric power, the water of the dam can also be used for fishing, it can also be used for soil conservation, afforestation, also it can help in growth of tourism. So as multiple benefits are derived from the projects, that's why we call it multi-purpose river valley projects. Now since independence, a number of such multi-purpose river valley projects have been constructed, and now if you look, almost all the major rivers of India have got such kind of projects. In fact, some of the rivers may be having 2 to 3 such projects. We'll be discussing one such project, that is Damodar Valley project. Now Damodar Valley project was actually the first multi-purpose river valley project that was constructed in India after it got independence. Actually, the river Damodar, on which this project is located, it actually rises from the Palamu district of Jharkhand and mainly flowing through Ranchi, Hazaribagh and Palamu district of Jharkhand. It actually enters West Bengal. Mainly it flows through Burdwan and Hooghly district before joining the river Hooghly near Falta, and ultimately it ends into the Bay of Bengal. Basically, the river Damodar is a tributary of the river Hooghly. Now, the river Damodar in the past actually was often referred to as the river of sorrow. Now, what used to happen was that the tributaries of the river during the rainy season used to bring plenty of water into the main river. And this river, especially in its lower course in Bengal, often used to flood. That's why it was often referred to as the river of sorrow. Now, this project was actually envisaged, and the idea was taken from Tennessee River Valley project, which is Tennessee River Valley project, which is located in USA. Now, similar to this Damodar River, this river also had its tributaries which used to bring plenty of water. So based on that, the Damodar Valley project was actually envisaged based on this Tennessee River Valley project. Now, originally this project for this project, an act of parliament was passed in 1948 by which Damodar Valley Corporation was set up. Now, what this project has actually done, 4 dams actually has been constructed like this. River Damodar flowing like this. Now, one of its tributaries, that is Barakar. One dam has been constructed at Tilaiya. Another dam on Barakar has been constructed at place called Mathon. Then another tributary by the name of Konar, in which also one dam has been constructed. And near about Dhanbad, another dam at Panchet has been constructed. And number of barrages has been constructed. One is at Durgapur. And another one at Tenu Ghat. Another barrage has been constructed. Just to give you an idea, the basic difference between a dam and a barrage. In case of the dams, they are much more bigger, can store huge amount of water. But barrages are of course of lower height. They can only store water up to a certain height. Ek height tak hi usme pani rahega. Of course, both of them are constructed across the river. Suppose this is the river and a barrage has been constructed. After a certain height, this water will store, but thereafter water will start flowing. But in case of the dam, it cannot happen. Dam, the river water won't accumulate so much that it is flowing over the dam. It won't happen. But in case of barrage, only a certain amount, certain height is there. After that, water will start flowing. Of course, both of them have what we call gates or sluice gates, which are opened from time to time to let out the water. Plenty of water, if it accumulates, then they are allowed to go out from these sluice gates. Okay, now this Damodar Valley project, main objective of the project was of course to control the flood, irrigation, then of course generation of power, then supply of water for domestic as well as industrial use, afforestation, social and economic welfare. These were some of the objectives with which this project was set up. In Damodar Valley project, at present there are three thermal power stations which are located at Durgapur, Bokaro and Chandrapur. There are three hydel power stations at Tilaiya, Maithon as well as Panchet. All these places have hydel power station, and there is one gas turbine station located at Maithon only. Well, as a result of this project, one thing has been for sure, the floods, which was a common occurrence, it has been under control. River Damodar, which was known as the river of sorrow, has now become river of prosperity. In fact, it has also resulted in afforestation and soil conservation. It has also helped in the irrigation, particularly in the areas of Bengal and Jharkhand. Power, of course, as I was mentioning, it supplies power through three thermal power and of course three hydel power stations, and of course gas turbine is also there, and it has also led to the industrial development in many areas and of course helped in the growth of tourism. Particularly Maithon, Panchet and Tilaiya have become tourist ports where people go very frequently. Now, about other multi-purpose river valley projects, you need to know some of the names, particularly why they are important. Names, I have given you the list also in the slide, why they are important. Just a passing mention. Highest dam in India is actually Tehri Dam on river Bhagirathi, located in Uttarakhand. That is the highest dam. Isse pehle, Tehri Dam se pehle, ye position tha Bhakra Nangal ka. Bhakra Nangal Dam, it was the highest dam. Tumhara kuch kuch book mein abhi bhi ye mention milega, but it is the second highest dam at present. Bhakra and Nangal, ye dono actually alag alag hai. Dono ek jagah pe nahi hai. These are two separate dams which are part of one Bhakra Nangal Corporation, isliye ek saath hi kaha jata hai. But these are in totally separate dams. Iske alawa, you also need to know the longest dam that is there, Hirakud Dam, which is located on river Mahanadi. So remember, try to remember the name of these dams. Okay, apart from this, one more thing that you need to know is of course the last part of the chapter, that is conservation of water. Well, conservation of water, of course, is necessary because fresh water, if you remember the first part of the video slide I had given the last week, where I had mentioned 97% of the water is of no use to the human beings. 3% is only fresh water, that too 2% is in the form of ice. Only 1% is of use. So we need to conserve our water. And conservation can be done by two ways. One is watershed development. Watershed development. And the second one is, of course, rainwater harvesting. Watershed, if you remember the term, watershed actually is the highland area which from where supply of water is there. Watershed or water divide, any highland area on one side, the river systems that are there totally separated by another river systems which may be located on the other side. So in watershed development, all the means of water which percolates down from the rivers, from the rainwater, they should be, aim should be to collect them in one way or other and use them in a proper manner. And also the idea should be, in case of the watershed development, the replenishment of the groundwater levels. It should not be wasted water which we get from the rainfall or other sources. It should not be wasted at any cost. Now, in India, of course, watershed development projects have been going on. One such famous project is Hariyali project, which is for development of watershed. It, of course, involves planting of trees so that natural runoff can be checked. Also, preventing soil erosion. All these methods are actually practiced in watershed development. Rainwater harvesting is the use of natural rainwater for various purposes. This rainwater harvesting is the collection and storage of the rainwater to meet the water requirements at the time of need, or especially during the period when there is lack of rainfall. This rainwater harvesting is more common in the southern part of the country where there is lack of rainfall. Especially in Bengal, as we get plenty of rainfall, we are not very much into the rainwater harvesting. Now, rainwater harvesting, of course, has its benefits. Rainwater is stored either in the overhead tanks, or it is collected through the pipes, goes to the ground where it is stored in the storage tanks. Now, this groundwater can be used for various requirements, or also it can be used for replenishing groundwater levels. Tamil Nadu is actually one such state where the rainwater harvesting actually has been very much successful. In fact, in Tamil Nadu, since 2001, a law was actually passed in which any new construction would not be permitted without having the facility of rainwater harvesting. And within a period of 5 years only, this act that was actually implemented, initially of course it was opposed by the people, but later on it was found out within 5 years how much benefit it had resulted. Chennai, which was always prone to water shortages, it actually got the benefit of rainwater harvesting. In fact, groundwater levels increased drastically in Tamil Nadu, and as a result of which, the Tamil Nadu model is being followed in other parts of the country. Now, that was all in this chapter. I am again repeating, this chapter is very important. I have given at the end of the slide certain questions which are important to this chapter. Please go through the chapter, and especially the long questions as well as the short questions that are there. Please go through them. Don't neglect the chapters. And I have already noticed that many of you are not actually writing down the answers in your copy. Maybe you are thinking that at the time of examination, you will be doing everything. But remember, you are in class 10. You cannot actually take the things lightly. Again, if you have any kind of problem, I have told you earlier also, you can always call me between 6 to 7 p.m. You can call me in my number if you have any kind of problem understanding the chapter. Next week, we'll deal with the climate of India. Have a good day.